I hope that you had a great evening and that you are ready for another morning of amazing presentations. We're going to get off to a fun start with our first speaker, Mark Dunbar. At one time or another, I think we would all agree that men and women tend to use different thought processes. In this presentation, Mark is going to discuss how you can better interact with the opposite sex, whether business or marriage, by taking the time to understand why people do what they do. And I guarantee he will make you laugh as he delivers some insight into what makes relationships work. Please welcome Mark Dunbar.
Like a Las Vegas magician. I'm a relationship speaker. I travel all around the world, helping men and women succeed in relationships, particularly in marriage. Now, relationships are very hard. They're supposed to be hard. Anything of great value in life is difficult. You should know this. You're successful people. Success doesn't happen automatically. It's a result of intentional work and effort. I tell married people all the time, look, what your spouse does may irritate you until the day you die. The good news is, you die. I want to talk about how men and women tend to think very differently from each other. That's why we have the two heads. Why is this important? Because we're very quick to make into heart problems what are really head problems. In other words, a man acts and thinks in a certain way, a woman doesn't understand it, she assumes he has a bad heart. It's not his heart, it's his head. We have the same problem with women. I'm going to be speaking to you in basic stereotypes, okay? In other words, men generally tend to think a certain way. Women generally tend to think a certain way. They don't all think that way. I understand that. All right? These are just stereotypes. They're generalities. And part of the fun of this session, since I forgot where you fit in the midst of this, I will say this, that if a woman sometimes thinks more like a man in a certain area, without doubt, her husband will think more like a woman in that same area. You almost never find couples who think the same. It's like these differences draw us towards each other, like a slow-moving car wreck. And then we drive each other crazy. And make no mistake, every single argument in marriage boils down to one very simple argument. Why can't you be more like me? Because clearly I am brilliant, and you are mentally ill. So these are just generalities, okay? Stereotypes. For example, the typical stereotype. Men are more interested in sex than their wives. Why would you say that? Because generally speaking, it's true. But it's not always true. There are many relationships where it is the wife who's much more interested in sex than her husband. If you're here this morning and you happen to be in a relationship where your wife is much more interested in sex than you, I think I speak for all the men here when I say that we hate you. Let's begin with the man's brains. Now, men's brains are made up of little boxes. You have a box for everything. A compartmentalized life. You have a box for the house. You have a box for the job. You have a box for the children. You have a box for the money. You have a box for you. Have a box for your mother, someplace in the basement. And the rule is very simple, ladies. The boxes do not touch. When a man discusses a particular subject, he goes to the appropriate box. He slides it out. He opens it up. He will freely discuss the contents of that particular box. And then when he is finished, he will fold it up and
straight away, being ever so careful not to touch nor disturb any of the other boxes, because the boxes do not touch.
Then we have a female brain. Now, the female brain is very different. The female brain is made of a big ball of wire. And it's like the internet, where everything is connected to everything. And the house is connected to the job, and the job is connected to the money, and the money is connected to the children, and the children is connected to your mother, and you go from one thing to another thing. La, 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 la. Because every picture is very, everything is connected. And the more obscure the connection, the greater the joy to the soul. And she jumped from one thing to this and to that. Of course, her husband's very confused. And he's listening to her going. What box are you in? You don't jump from box to box. She loves to make the connections. Of course, she expects the man to connect as well. And what women do not understand is we do not make the connections. But she assumes you make the connections. That's why women won't just clearly ask for what they want. She hints. She suggests. She implies. She thinks to herself, surely he's a great devil. And he can make the connections. But we do not connect. Ladies, if you want something from a man, just say it. Just going to get something to eat can be very problematic. Where do you want to eat? I don't care. Let's go to that steak place. I hate it. Well, let's get some Mexican food. I don't feel like Mexican food. Well, where do you want to eat? I don't care. Apparently you do. Now, all of this connecting is driven by energy that we call emotion. It's one of the reasons why women tend to remember everything. Because it's a scientific fact that if you take an event and you connect it to an emotion, it will burn into your memory and you can remember forever. The same thing happens for men. It just doesn't happen very often. Because quite frankly, we don't care. Women care about everything. Now we men have a box in our brains that most women do not know about. This particular box has nothing in it. In fact, we call it the nothing box. And of all the boxes a man has in his brain, our nothing box is our favorite box. The man has the opportunity to go to his nothing box every time. This is why a man can do something completely brain dead for hours on end. Like fishing. This is why a man can sit in front of a TV set and go, across the stripes, our lives crazy. What are you doing? You can't possibly be watching anything. I'm not. Go away. Now, they've actually studied. There's a big university in the United States, 5, 6, 7 years ago, did a big study on brain activity. They were the ones that discovered that, in fact, men have the ability to
machines apparently never stopped. They would bring women into the laboratories, put wires on their heads. They're sitting there doing nothing. And they monitor the brain activity from the women. When they brought in the men, monitor their brains. In fact, they said up to 70% of a man's brain activity completely shuts down when he's relaxing. When a man is relaxing, he's relaxing. But people don't understand this, and it drives them crazy. Because nothing is more frustrating to a woman than to witness a man doing nothing. How can you just sit there? And then she gets angry with him and stops talking to him.
Think this brilliant plan through.
A woman, in an effort to punish the man, stops talking to him. That's like giving a bottle to a white man. She's over here thinking, I'm teaching him a lesson. And he's over here thinking, thank God she's got it.
Something good.
Until she explodes later. He has no idea what's going on. Women do not understand the nothing box. A woman will witness a man in that glorious vegetative state. And she'll come up to him.
What are you thinking about?
You have to be thinking about something. But no, he thinks about money. Now, this is affects the way that men and women handle stress. Because when a man is feeling stressed, ladies, the last thing in the world he wants to do is talk about it. He doesn't want to talk about it. He wants to go through his nothing box and think about nothing. This is how a man handles stress. Clear the mind. But when a woman is stressed, she must talk about it. If she does not talk about it, she will go crazy. In fact, there was a big heart study that came out of England several years ago talking about heart attacks and strokes. And they discovered something very fascinating. They saw a big difference between men and women. They said in their study that when a woman is stressed, if she's not allowed to verbalize her frustration, it will literally physically damage her heart and increase her risk of stroke and heart attack. Isn't that amazing? I mean, if she acts like she's going to die if she does not talk, she's going to die if she does not talk. It makes no sense to us. Now, because they love each other, they offer to each other their best solution to stress. A man can tell the girl is stressed. He loves the girl. He cares about the girl. So out of the love of his heart, he offers to her his best solution to stress. Stop thinking about it. Of course, now she thinks he's being an insensitive monster. And in point of fact, that's the best we have. Because it actually works for him. But women are just as guilty. Or you can tell her husband is stressed. She loves the boy. She cares about the boy. So out of the love of her heart, she offers to him her best solution to stress.
Talk to me. Why won't you talk to me?
Words in a day. A woman needs to use 20,000
1,000 words in a day. My wife says,
that's because we have to repeat everything we say.
To which I responded, my wife is here with me. We just celebrated our 42nd wedding anniversary. We have 2 children and 6 glorious grandchildren. Anybody here have grandchildren? Is it not the most fabulous experience of life? It is wonderful. It is God's reward for not killing your children. Years. I remember on our 30th wedding anniversary, my son Philip calls me up and says, hey Dad, 30 years, congratulations. I said, thank you, son. Then he goes, no, really, that's a long time. I said, yes, but it seems like just 10 minutes. He says, really? I said, yes, 10 minutes. And they were. Don't worry, ladies. It's just a joke from the joke box. Not connected to anything. Not only do men and women use different amounts of words, words themselves can mean totally different things to men. For example, man, 5 minutes actually means 5 minutes. To a lot of women, it's an indefinite period of time. Are you ready yet?
5 minutes!
Now, as we have already shared, men love, cherish, and appreciate nothing. You men do not understand nothing. If a woman tells you it's nothing, look out, see for you. Amen. You think I'm a clever? Look at her. You think I don't know why you think she's mad? What did she say? She said it's nothing. Get out, run, run! This was not actually a word, but it's a vocalization simply a sound to make a sound. Now, when a man sighs, it means everything is good with life. When a woman sighs, it means you are an idiot. Says go ahead, he's being polite. When a woman says go ahead, this is a dare. And you have to be very careful with how you respond because it will most likely be followed by a sign. And then you will have an argument about nothing. And then you won't have sex again for at least 5 minutes. Men's faith rooms also affects the way that we listen. And people say, men do not listen. But we listen. We just listen differently. You see, it's what I call the difference between single tasking and multitasking. Now, generally speaking, men are single taskers. They do one thing at a time. They can do it very well. And we usually do it in sequential order. Women, on the other hand, tend to be multitaskers. They can juggle many things at once. In any order, it doesn't matter. Even when a woman is home and she is relaxing, she can be watching television, talking on the phone, and reading a book all at the same time. And know where her three children are and what they're doing at any moment. Whereas a man is just vaguely aware that there's a little people. Now, this is reflected physically in how men and women's eyes are designed. You see, men's eyes are designed like hanging binoculars. Good for the hunting and focusing we've done throughout the ages. But just like binoculars, unless a man's eyes fall right on what he's looking for, he cannot see it. Women's eyes are like wide-angle lenses. And they instantly give up detail. A woman can walk into a room and in 5 minutes notice more detail in that room than he has noticed in 5 years. Of course, this works its way into the home. This is why a man can walk into the kitchen, open the cupboard, and know. Hey, where's the salt? And she'll say, sweat in front of your face. I can see it! And then she comes over and as if by voodoo magic, there's an instant here. It's right here! Now this does not make women superior to men, it just makes us different. It's also why many women have a difficult time reading low books. It's true, there's something to this. You see, when a man looks at a woman, the minute he sees where he is and where he wants to go, all the other lies disappear. We don't even see them. They are no problem. But because of the way a woman's eyes are shown to the world, she tends to see all the lies at once. And it can be very confusing. That's why you can be driving in your car and go, where are we? I don't know, there's too many lines. This does not make men superior, so it just makes us different. And it's like I'm going to keep still listening. Just what women do not understand about a man as a single dazzler. Ladies, when a man is doing something, generally speaking, he hears it. If a man is doing something, don't be giving him important information. Now, women do not have this problem. A woman can be in a crowded room talking to another woman and follow the details of two other conversations around her at the same time. It's creepy what you do. Consequently, we get ourselves involved. Now then, if you can tell your wife's trying to talk to you, stop doing what you're doing. If the woman's talking to you, stop doing what you're doing. Look at the woman, get the information, and then you can go back to what you're doing. You'll find life will be much nicer to you. With women, they're multitasking. This is in trouble all the time. I started being better because I'm a bad single. That's right. I think about one thing at a time. My wife would get mad. She'd start talking. I'd go, no, wait. What did you say? And I would get the information. And then I would go back to her. I was doing much better. But still, I would get in trouble. She would walk up to me and say, 6 o'clock, are you ready? Go out. I told you. No, you didn't. Yes, I did. And we would start to fight. And you would swear, I told you. And I never remember hearing her. She was convincing me I was going deaf. I decided to do a test. I wanted to see how far away she got before I could stop hearing her. So she's next to me in the kitchen talking the next morning. La 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 la. I could hear her fine. She gets to the middle of the kitchen. Blah, 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 blah.
I can hear her phone.
She gets to the end of the kitchen.
I can hear her phone.
But then I watched in amazement as she turns her back, walking into the next room, and then into another room. And she's still talking to me. Talking so bad one day. He said, it's so true, I have this problem. He says, my wife should be kneeling in front of the dryer. What a dryer is that? Washer dryer. My wife would be kneeling in front of the dryer, talking to me, and stick her hand in the dryer. You better be paying attention, because you're going to be in big trouble if you don't forget to tell this to the boys, and I need it. Another man came to me, he says, you know, I'll be in the toilet. The door is closed. The fan is on. She's still going to talk to me. So this is not always our problem, ladies. Yes, men have to focus to listen. But sometimes women are so busy multitasking, they talk all over the place. They get themselves in all kinds of trouble because the laws of physics still apply to you. If you're in another room,
we cannot hear you.
Multitasking. Now, you can really tell your wife is a multitasker. And during a moment of intimate passion, she suddenly speaks out. And by the way, the plumber says the toilets are broken. Focus, woman, focus! She can make love to you, think about toilets, planning speech dinners. Well, in no other area do men and women think more differently than when it comes to the area of sex. And I don't have time to give you my complete sex talk. Can I give you just a little bit? Now, when it comes to sex, it's very important to men. Men are very interested because of testosterone. It enters our blood and it makes us crazy. In fact, if you women truly knew how crazy this man is, he would be more disgusted with us than you are right now. But it has a medical foundation. It's called testosterone. Now, our testosterone level peaks at about age 18. So if you look to make a graph, it looks like this. The line is children. And then it peaks at age 18. And then it goes down. Why not explain to you why God made men this way? We have to do under anatomy lesson. We stay calm, it will be nice and safe. And we will call this the girl's heart. And to be very polite, people call this the place of happiness. Now, ladies, something you have to understand. That the main interest a man has in a woman is this. Now, it's not the only thing, but it's the fundamental thing. But what so many men do not understand is that the key to this is actually this. And if he touches this, then his wife says, okay, now you can touch this. Am I going too fast? So when that sex drive hits you, it's not so you can awaken your wife in the dead of night and say, hey, be awake. It's really to remind you, be nice to the girl. Be nice to the girl. Well, women are very different. A woman's main interest in a man is this. But what so many millions of women do not understand is that the key to this is this. You touch out, now you can touch this. And let me tell you, man, why this is so important. Because
because the key to a woman's heart is very powerful. I'm going to end by telling you men something men have wanted to know for thousands of years. I want to tell you what women want. It's a big deal. It's been the problem of coming this morning. I want to tell you what women want is to feel chosen. All of life for a woman is she's at the dance, hoping some boy will come and choose to dance with her. This is how she delights during the dating process. You spend time with her and choose to be with her. This is why her girlfriends celebrate with her and envy her at the same time on her wedding day. All right, she's been chosen. When somebody gonna choose me? But then men make this fatal mistake. When they say, I do, they think it means I'm done. And they stop choosing the girl. Now everything else becomes more important. Money becomes more important. Career becomes more important. Sports becomes more important. Video games, his friends, everything becomes more important. And now she begins to suffocate emotionally. The man who can continually demonstrate to his wife that out of everything else, I still choose you, is the man who can make a woman feel in love with him his entire life. Now, the good news is this. You don't have to do this every day. Women are not weak, needy, pod creatures from another planet. Actually, they are pod creatures from another planet. But they're not weak and needy. But if you go days, weeks, months, and everything's more important than her, you will find yourself in big trouble. Always remember the priority. Make her feel special. It doesn't have to be all the time, every day, but take that time. Set everything aside, and you will find that you will be much happier than if you aren't. In closing, let me just say this. I want to thank FDIT for inviting me to come. When they first asked me to come about a year ago, I said, no, I cannot come because my wife was very, very sick. She had been diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer, and in a very, very limited time to live, I thought, my beginning of this year, she would have been dead. A year ago, we thought she wasn't going to make it. But then, amazingly, miraculously, she just started getting better, and they don't know why. There's no explanation. The only explanation is that God still answers prayers, and we're so grateful for that. So thank you for inviting me. God bless all of you. Have a wonderful rest of the day.